Let's get some drinks going. What do you fancy? Pina colada?
What's that fizzy stuff over there?
Limeade?
Yeah, limeade.
You really want some of this?
Yeah, that's what I want.
Yeah, well, I got you these, because I'll have a pina colada. You have that, because just I saw this. You in Rio.
Oh, with a coconut?
Yeah, that's what I thought. Aww. Let me just pour your limeade.
Thanks.
It's nice, isn't it?
I'm living the dream.
Now, get yourself
and a straw.
What did you make of Rio? Did you like it?
It was amazing. Yeah.
And they're fit as well, Brazilians, aren't they?
Oh, yeah.
They are fit. Even the tramps, you're like, woof. Yeah. Oh. And they walk around in bikinis and honestly, thongs. Seriously.
Everybody wears a thong. Yeah. Everyone.
You go to the supermarket and there's like a woman. Honestly, it's like a Benny Hill sketch. She's picking two melons and she's got this bikini. And I'm like, And so you're over there doing a gig.
Yeah, I did Rock in Rio, which was amazing. It was like 125,000 people.
No way.
Yeah, it was like probably the biggest gig live amount of people I've ever done. Alicia Keys was there, Justin Timberlake, Beyonce did the night before.
You ran a competition for a fan to design your stage outfit.
Yeah, I did.
So why did you choose this one as the winner?
That's probably not a question.
No, I just talk me through it. I'm intrigued about the green vagina. I mean, it's not a built-in camel toe.
That's exactly what I wanted. It was on the brief. I was like, yeah, can I have a camel hoof lime-coloured crutch?
Yeah.
Tick.
Now, I haven't seen you since you shaved all your hair off.
Ta-da.
Yeah, look at it. Can I just touch it?
Yeah, it's very crispy.
Crispy?
Yeah, it's like a meringue.
Yeah, it is like a meringue.
It's like, so it doesn't move.
Yeah.
Cos my hair's,
how can it move? It's that short.
No, trust me, it grows. My hair's really thick, and now I've cut it all off. Like, on stage, I'll come off, I look like a fluffy duck.
How much money did you raise? Cos you shaved it off for Comic Relief.
Well, I saw Richard Curtis, the founder, about 3 weeks ago, and he said they've now raised, altogether, over 100 million, which is the most they've ever done. So I'm so happy that I did it.
That's amazing.
Yeah.
Because there was the conspiracy theory that you had nits and stuff like that. I don't know who makes these stories up. I mean, it's just bang out of order. Have you been getting more offers since you had it done?
What kind of offers?
Oh. people want to dip your straw in your coconut. You know what I mean?
I think I'm more approachable. I think I became a bit of a cartoon character with the bob and the pale skin, and I kind of let too many people have a say on my look. And as soon as I kind of took control back and saw some photos and was like, it wasn't fancy dress, Jess. I kind of felt like I looked more soft and more like me. I feel like more like me now.
Yeah. American, I'm well enough here, that's beautiful. You said you're too busy for a relationship, but you want kids.
That doesn't work, does it?
I was going to say, someone has to break it to your love.
Yeah. So it works like this. There's a straw and a coconut.
So now, how's it going to work?
All in good time. Yeah, I mean, a lot of people say to me, like, what's your biggest dreams in life? And obviously, everyone has their career, but their personal dreams too. And I do want to be a mum one day. Mm. But I have to find someone. Oh. And it's really hard when there's no fit people in the airport. Why are good looking people not going on holiday?
Because you're being shagged properly.
Not by me, sadly.
Oh, no.
Yeah, but no, all in good time. I'm very focused on my career and.
Oh, okay. Well, it's going so well and everything.
Oh, yeah.
There'll be time for a kid. And you got a dog, haven't you?
I'm going to be careful how I answer this, because I don't want to know people... Jessie J dates her dog.
Is he toilet trained?
He is now.
Yeah.
He had his moments where he wasn't. And he pooed everywhere.
Oh.
Tom Jones, his dressing room.
How do you know it wasn't Tom, though?
No,
I'm joking. We love Tom. Does he have because you wear a lot of leopard skin print, does he
does he panic or attack me?
No, does he ever think you're his mother? idea of
Well, I suppose he does think I'm his mum, cos I picked him up when he was 8 weeks old.
Oh.
And, obviously, their biggest thing is their scent.
He doesn't try to suckle you or anything.
No, he does not try to suckle me.
It happened to me once, thank you. At a petting zoo, thank you. No, I was bending over and this goat... Anyway, it's a long story. Seriously, thank you.
But no, we are not dating. I've never had sex with my dog.
Chatty Man exclusive. Now, your new album, Alive, is out next week.
You wrote,
yes, I know. I love those hoop earrings.
Thank you.
You wrote it in 5 weeks.
I did, yeah. Over five weeks was the amount of studio time I had over a year.
Yeah.
So, like, I kind of put the days together and realised that I wrote this album in 5 weeks. The first one was nearly 7 years, so it was a big change, yeah. I just basically write about my life.
Yeah.
Yeah. Everything that's on the album is very honest and very true, but obviously my life's very different now. You know,
yeah,
like it's
yeah.
completely different from when I wrote the first album. But I kind of just exaggerate moments in my life and make them into songs.
Dizzy Rascal, Big Sean, and Brandy all
yes.
appear on it. Have you gone all brap 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 for us?
The inside rocker. That's the intro to the album. Why did you spread your legs when I did that?
Because I wanted to do the butterfly.
Oh, the butterfly.
Rihanna. Rihanna talked with a butterfly.
Amazing.
And the dirty wine. Thank you. Funny, that's the noise my thighs make when I do it.
No, I mean, having Brandy, there's a duet with myself and Brandy. She's one of my favourite singers
yeah.
of all time. And yeah, I feel very, very lucky to have her on the album.
You're touring America with Robin Thicke.
Yes.
Next year.
Yes.
We're not going to see you scratching your tuppence with a sponge finger, are we?
No. Oh.
I mean, I hear he's highly sexed.
I'm actually shooting a video of Robin next week.
Oh, my God. Kick some mace, that's all I can say. He's on my show. He's coming on my show.
He's amazing.
In a couple
he's
of
such
weeks.
A nice guy. Such a nice guy.
Well, I've heard all these rumours. I've had a chub lock put on my dressing room.
No.
It's thick. I say, how thick? No one. What did you make of all the Miley Cyrus business at the VMAs? Are you pro or anti twerking?
I think I'm. Oh, no. Okay.
I get this feeling you're editing yourself.
Yeah. I think, okay, so it's a weird subject because I don't actually, I don't know, I don't find it funny or anything. I actually find it quite sad.
Mm.
No, I do. I find it sad. I think it's, she's really young. And yes. I don't know, I feel like I know how hard it is to break away from a character that the world have created.
Yeah,
and I think
yeah.
people want to meet Hannah Montana, and she's not Hannah Montana.
No.
She's Miley Cyrus, but she's
still... She's Hannah Las Vegas.
Yeah, she's very young still. She's only 20, and I just feel like, yeah, I just think... I don't think it should have been as celebrated as it was, in my opinion. I know I've been there, though. I remember when Dude came out, everyone was like, whoa, you know, and so I understand that sometimes you do things and you go... I've done it now. There's no way of testing in the public until you do it.
No.
Whether you know it's wrong or right. And sometimes you convince yourself that something's right and then you watch it back and go, really?
Yeah.
But I just hope that people around her are guiding her in the right way because, yeah.
Yeah. Yeah. Well said.
I think she's great though. I just really her new song I think is amazing. Wreckable is amazing.
Yeah, yeah. Anyway, listen, we've got to take a break there, Jessie.
Okay.
Join us again in a couple of minutes when Jessie will be chatting and performing. See you in part four. Welcome back to part four of my Chatty Man 80s special. Look who's still here. It's only Jessie Bloom and Jay. You like tweeting.
Yes.
And your Instagram and all your photos. But
yes.
Obviously, if you don't like Twitter, I should tell you about the Chatty Man CFAX page, which...
Amazing.
If you don't remember the 80s, and CFAX was sort of like Twitter.
This.
But shit. It's got exclusive backstage chat and pictures. And If you want to know what the weather is, there you go. Page 455, you can't miss it, OK? Now, I've got to ask you about The Voice. You're not doing it this series.
No.
Oh. Why have you...
Someone's like, woo! Saturday night's back. Woo!
Oh, well, I mean, that must be great, getting your Saturday night's back.
There I am, looking really serious.
Yes, yes.
That doesn't even look like me. It's really weird.
No, it is funny how you've changed.
No, you have,
it is strange, though. I see myself dark hair and I'm like, that's weird.
Yeah.
I literally just cannot... I'm too busy. I have to do my tour. So I had to prioritise, and for me, my music is always my priority. I wouldn't have been on the show had I not had an album out, so...
There was always stories in the paper making out that you were a diva backstage.
That's me being a diva. That's as diva as
I know. I'm not just saying it because you're here, but you are probably the least diva person.
Yeah.
Did that just get on your nerves, people? Because I know they tried to stir up shit, but was that a reason why you're like, oh, I don't think I can be bothered with this?
It did get ridiculous to a point where I was like, where are they creating this from?
Yeah.
Like, that I demanded 30 chairs in my dressing room. Why would I need to do that unless I had a kids' party? You know what I mean? It was weird, and, like, I was late. I was never late. I was always the first there. Mm. Not naming names, who was last. Will. But, but yeah, I am myself. And
well, you did have to come in from Mars.
Yeah,
you know,
exactly.
Will.
Yeah.
On my way.
Yeah. I was like, car parking space is a circle on the roof. Spaceship to land. But no, I loved being on the show, and you do have to always get the bad with the good. And what show has never had that female diva? Talisa got it, Kelly Rowland's had it, Nicole's had it, I've had it, Kylie's gonna get it.
Yeah.
You know? And Kylie's the sweetest person ever, so who knows what they're gonna make up about her.
So, how do you think as Kylie is your replacement?
I think it's amazing that Kylie's doing it. I think it's gonna be really interesting to see what she brings. I thought you were gonna put a picture up then. Every time I say Kylie, another picture. There it is. The picture comes up.
I thought you had a lazy eye. I didn't want to mention it.
But no, I think she's gonna be great. I hope that she's tough though.
Yeah.
I hope that she's critical, because that's what I want to be replaced with as well, because I felt like I was the most honest.
Yeah, we don't want nice Kylie.
No.
We want bitch Kylie.
Constructive Kylie.
Yeah. But I think, you know, I love Kylie's ass. And I just think it's a waste to be on that chair.
But please, I hope that they play I'm spinning around. And she goes round every time. She'd be like, I'm spinning around.
Yeah, showing her ass. I'm spinning around. I'd love it. Good luck with the live.
Thank you.
When's it out?
23rd of September.
Yes. Oh, I can't wait.